is involved in the movement of lower limb. That means there must be plenty of muscles that assist in motion. We are going to study all the muscle attachments of the femur bone. For quick and easy learning, let us study muscles of each part separately. Remember, medial means toward the midline of the body and lateral means away from the body. Starting with the proximal region, I would like you to remember the landmarks of the femur while going forward with the muscular attachments, as it will help you to have a strong grip to the topic. The fovea capitis, known as the small depression on the head of the femur, is the place where ligamentum teres attaches. Obturator externus muscle attaches at the internal part of the greater trochanter on the neck. Lesser trochanter is the site of attachment for iliopsoas muscle, forceful contraction of which can cause an avulsion fracture of the lesser trochanter. Intertrochanteric line is the site of attachment for the iliofemoral ligament, the strongest ligament of the hip joint, serving as the anterior attachment of the hip joint capsule. There is a rounded tubercle on superior half of intertrochanteric crest called the quadrate tubercle, where quadratus femoris muscle attaches. Greater trochanter is the site of attachment for many of the muscles in the gluteal region. There are two gluteus muscles here, the gluteus medius and the gluteus minimus, and the piriformis muscle. There is an exception of the muscle vastus lateralis that originates from this site, unlike being inserted. An avulsion fracture of the greater trochanter can occur as a result of forceful contraction of the gluteus medius. A third gluteal muscle attaches to the gluteal tuberosity, which is the gluteus maximus, which is your butt muscle. On the linea aspera, remember that we have three vastus muscles here, which help to extend the knee. The vastus medialis, vastus lateralis muscle that originates from the greater trochanter and runs down. Between them is the vastus intermedialis and three adductor muscles, adductor magnus, adductor brevis, and adductor longus muscle. However, the adductor magnus tendon has insertion site on the adductor tubercle, which is a small bump on the distal end of the femur. We also have biceps femoris and pectineus muscle. Articularis genu muscle attaches at the lower end of the shaft on the anterior aspect. On the distal end, we can already see the insertion of the tendon of the adductor magnus at adductor tubercle. On the distal region, we have two epicondyles, the lateral epicondyle and the medial epicondyle. On the lateral side, we have the attachment of fibular collateral ligament of the knee on the supracondylar line. On the medial side, we have two attachment heads for gastrocnemius muscle. And this is the main calf muscle which runs down to Achilles tendon, helping in the flexion of the knee and foot. Popliteus muscle originates from lateral condyle of femur, which is the deepest muscle acting solely on the knee, unlike other muscles which articulates with the ankle as well. Changing the view a bit, on the intercondylar notch, intercondylar fossa contains two fascias for the attachment of intracapsular knee ligaments. On the medial aspect of lateral condyle, we have anterior cruciate ligament, and on the lateral aspect of the medial condyle, we have the posterior cruciate ligament. Now, if you look at this, on medial condyle, lateral aspect, there is posterior cruciate ligament or PCL, and on the lateral condyle and medial aspect, there is anterior cruciate ligament or ACL. See how condyle and aspect are opposite to each other. So you can remember this easily by remembering the LM and AP. So these are all the muscles that we just talked about and that help in the movement of femur. Show your comments in the comment section below. They are highly appreciated, and keep watching Scardio.com.